guilt. I think I've found out since meeting somebody in the last year that I'm accidentally a research software engineer. I actually work with audio in all sorts of different projects, and I've come from a background in music and music technology with a mixture of physics and acoustics thrown in. Some of the projects, the pictures up here, relate to recent projects I've been involved in, and these are using sound in a variety of different ways. So in each of these I've been either the solo developer of the software or else working with one or two others. But the idea is to package up the kind of research tools we have available into real life, real time audio tasks. So off the left you can see these are the idea here is for a language lab where we have pronunciation assessment. In fact, the project I was in was working with school children in the Netherlands, assessing their pronunciation on a very small time scale, so like individual sounds of speech. Also, be working with cochlear implant listeners, and these are building language learning tools on a more longer term time scale. So, they receive rehabilitation in the NHS for one-to-one conversation, but not to join in group conversations. So we have worked on a way to have software for that. At the moment, I'm working with a company who are interested in snoring, and they want a way to assess whether their anti-snoring products are working. But my background, as I mentioned, is in music technology. So what I really do a lot of in my spare time is trying to get younger folk using these tools in real environments, and particularly girls. Because girls and women just completely drop out of music technology as you go through, as I did. So I'm trying to do something about putting that back in now. And that's me, I'm here to learn, so any tips you have, please.